And an upstate police chief is having trouble keeping officers on the force.
And he says it's because other agencies offer other better benefits. News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local in our Anderson newsroom. Mandy, the chief is hoping to change that, right?
Well, that's right, Carol. Anderson Police Chief Martin Brown is proposing a new plan that would give his officers more of an incentive to stick around. But his ideas have been met with mixed emotions by city council members.
When you have a police force of 95 officers, subtracting 47 of them seems like a big loss. But since 2006, that's what the Anderson police chief has faced. At least 25 of those officers have left in the past 2 years.
We've been trying to put our hands and get a grasp around it of why we're having so much exodus of officers going to other places.
But Anderson City Councilman Tony Stewart says Chief Martin Brown's plan to keep officers on his force isn't the answer. 2 years ago, the city allowed officers who lived in the limits of Anderson to take home their patrol cars, thinking their presence would keep neighborhoods safer. As part of a new three-part plan, the chief is now asking for all officers to be able to take home their cars, even if they live outside the city.
It's hard to justify sending a vehicle to another municipality and to have it at the expense burden of the city taxpayers, because they are the ones footing the bill while other neighborhoods or other communities are getting the benefits of feeling safe of it.
Do I think the idea is, you know, a good yes?
Not everyone is against the plan. City Councilman Matt Harbin says he'd like to hear more about it. But if taking cars home keeps officers in Anderson, he says it could save money in the long run. The spokesman for the police department says after training and certification, it costs about $35,000 for a new hire.
The amount of money that we spend to train those officers would be saved tenfold by the retention of the officers.
Retaining officers while watching taxpayer dollars, and the way to do both is what city council will have to try and figure out.
And two other parts of the plan include offering raises for officers who complete extra training, something Stewart says isn't fair to veteran officers who have already completed that training, and restructuring the force, having fewer officers on top and more of them on the street. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
Mandy, thank you. And Chief Martin Brown is expected to bring stats on how much it would cost to take vehicles home when the city's Public Safety Committee meets again at the end of the month. Full council would have to approve his plan.